Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will talk about a new tool that is introduced in Unreal Engine 5 called the Mirror Data Table, right here. Mirror Data Table simply allows you to mirror animations for your characters. So back in the Unreal 4 days, there wasn't a really good way to mirror your animation within the engine itself, and you may have to use a 3D software like Maya or Blender to mirror your animations. So in Unreal Engine 5, they added this new Mirror Data Table, which you can create by going to Animation tab, right-click Animation, and then there's a Mirror Data Table over here. And once you create it, if I open this up, you can see that all the bones are within this table, along with which bone you want to use as the mirrored animation name, right? And I'll go over this later. I'll just set this up in a bit. But first, I want to show you some examples of what you can use for it. So in terms of sequencer, here I have a simple reload animation and idle animation for the rifle. And if I want to mirror this animation, all I need to do is select on the animation tracks that I want to use, and then go to properties, and then just select the mirror data table, and then it'll be mirrored. So right now I have it mirrored already. So if I deselect it, so if I clear, you can see that it's back into the original animation that I have. And what I have set up is there's our two different rifles, so two different items. So I have these two rifles attached to the left hand and right hand. So if I have it in my original animation, I would just take the visibility of the right hand rifle, and then put the visibility of the left hand rifle off. So there's that. And if I want to mirror this animation, then it'll be the other way around. So I'll hide the right hand and turn on the visibility for the left hand rifle. So there you go. So that's pretty much how you will use for the sequencer. Another thing you can do with the mirror data is to use it within the character animation blueprint. So for example, let's say you're building a third-person shooter game, and there are instances where you may want to switch the aim angle from the right hand to the left hand, like this, where you're aiming and then your view is blocked. So by using the mirror data to change the view, you can simply make a system where you can change the angle of your camera and the animation itself. So it comes in pretty handy like that. And for this tutorial, I won't be showing you how you could exactly create this type of system because it's not within the scope of the video I planned. But I can briefly go over what I've done. So in the character animation blueprint here, in each of the animation states, I've added a mirror data animation node here, and then used a variable called is mirrored to check if the mirror button, which is F for me, is pressed or not. So, and back in the blueprint of the character, I used F as a flip-flop to create another mirror is mirrored here to set the whether is mirrored is activated or not. So I can change in the event graph of the animation data. I can grab the Trigate pawn owner and then cast it to the blueprint here itself, and then check its mirrored variable, and then set the is mirrored variable here over here. So whenever this is activated or not activated, it will change accordingly. So that is the gist of it. And I will make another video in the future about how you can set all these up so you can utilize in your third-person shooter game if you're building one. So without further ado, I'll show you guys how to make the mirror animation data itself. Taking the mannequin, Unreal 4 Engine mannequin, as an example. So if I want to make an animation mirror for this character, then I will go to animation, right click animation, and then mirror data table, right? And then it will prompt up this window where you can have to choose which skeleton you want to use. And the skeleton I'm using is this one. So it's probably Yes, this one. Yeah. So I'm going to choose the one that is correct for me and then press accept, and then it will make a mirror animation. I mean, a mirror data table. I'll rename it as example mannequin. All right, so there's that. And once you open it up, you can see that the data is already implemented by Unreal itself. The reason for this is because all the naming of the bones are already in the system where Unreal Engine is taking. So if your rig has the same bone names as the Unreal Engine mannequin, then if you create a new animation data table, it should technically help you already add in all these different bones into the table itself. And if not, there is also table details where you can go and edit where these are simply just it will search for the different kind of prefixes or suffixes of left and right that you might use. And if there are other ones that you aren't using that you want to use, you can pretty much just add an element and then just put in whatever expression that you want to use for your rig, right? So right here, those L and R's are exactly what this detail panel is trying to search for. So there's that. And another thing is that if you're using a Mixamo character, like this one I got from Mixamo as an example. Same thing if you do a animation mirror data table. This one. And if you open it, you can see that not all the bones are made, but some of the bones are made. And if I open that, you can see that the hips is not within this animation. It's not within this table. So naming convention will be pretty important if you want to automate all this mirror data table. And I also did another little test which I renamed the bones to have a test underscore prefix in it. So if I were to create a mirror data table here, then you can see there's nothing inside this table. So in this instance, you will need to create your bones one by one. So if you press an add, and then it will prompt up a new row, and then you have to like name everything one by one. So if it comes to that, then I would just pretty much copy the select bone name and then paste it here, and then the mirror name overall also, and then the naming of this row as the bone name itself. For the root, you will probably just use the same root for your mirror animation, right? The only ones where you want to switch between left and right is the legs and the arms. So if I was to do the right leg up, I would put in this as the name, and then name as that. Mirror name, I will be using left instead. And then you have to slowly build each of these bones that you want to use to mirror your animations. Yeah, so that is pretty much it. And just be sure some characters are different extra. Let me see. Yeah, so there might be different asymmetrical bones that you might use. So just be sure that when you're building all this mirror data, make sure that these are the ones that you exactly want to use in your mirror animation or not. So depending on what you want to use, you can add it in or not. So another thing with the mirror data table is, I forgot to say, in the data table details panel, there is the skeleton. And if all your rigs are named the same, you can essentially just pick another skeleton, and then it will work for that skeleton. So you could pretty much just like duplicate this and then go to the details tab. Switch between the skeleton to use another different character. So you don't have to go through and redo all these tables for each of your characters. So that comes in pretty handy. To use the mirror data table in a animation blueprint, we'll need to use the mirror pose node. So using my example for my third person shooter in the animation blueprint, I'm just going to use this. And if I go to my animation graph, I'm going to unlink this for now. And then let me grab the death 3 as an example. So if I link this death 3 animation into the upper pose, you can see that there is this animation that's playing. So in order to make this animation be mirrored within the animation blueprint, all you need to do is to drag out from the little person icon and then type in search for mirror. And you'll see this mirror pose node, which already has the mirror data table that you already have for the skeleton. So if you select this, if it's checked, then that means it's mirrored. If it's unchecked, then it's not mirrored, which is the original animation. So if I leave it as checked, you'll see that the animation is mirrored. And that's pretty much all you need to do for if you want to use a mirrored animation within the animation blueprint. So if I uncheck this, it will be the original already. Oh, original again. Yep. So basically, you would use a Boolean variable, which I have as is mirrored here, to check the status of the character player. And then I'll feed into if it's whether or not if it's mirrored or not. Yeah, so you will use this into all the different states that you have. So in here, I have, as said before, I have different like the mirror table over here. And within all these states, I have a separate mirror table and to check if it's mirrored or not. All right, and another thing is, let me just redo this, all this, and then go back into the idle standing. So within the mirror animation, the mirror pose node, there's a blend time over here. And you can utilize this to blend between the if you want the animation to be mirrored or not. Let me just make this one second first. So for the blend time to work, you'll need this initialization node as well. So if you don't have this, let me just make it like this. Compile, save. And if I play my game, you can see that the blend time is not working. It's just like popping between the mirrored animation and not mirrored animation. So that's the problem when you don't have the, oops, my bad. So that would be a problem if you don't have this node connected as well. So we will need this node in order for the blend time to work. So if I plug this in, you can see that the blend time is actually working. So that's the important piece of information that you will need if you want to utilize something, a system like what I have over here. So, and yeah, so that is basically what I want to share in this tutorial. Hopefully it will help you guys figure out some problems that you might are trying to like figure out during the development process. And good luck on whatever you are working on, and hopefully it's helpful for all of you. Thanks for watching, and as always, never stop learning.